Now, Harry, you must concentrate. You will never outrank he who must not be named unless you master the keyword spell I taught you. Once more, mesothelioma. Mesothelioma.
Mesotheliometer. Oh, dash. Mesotheliopotamus. Oh, dash it all.
Young Potter may never get this spell right, but your best keyword magic may be failing too. Here's why.
Eric, keywords still matter for SEO, right?
Well, they do, Mark, but how we use them has changed.
Oh, how so?
Well, it's still a good idea to plan what keywords you want to rank for, but the world of search is so complex now, it isn't just a matter of choosing some keywords, optimizing content for them, obtaining some links, and presto, you're ranking for those keywords.
Well, what else is involved then?
So, the key these days is understanding relevance to a query and how Google interprets user intent.
Explain that.
Sure. So let me give you an example. Here's a query where every result, except for some local results, is an e-commerce site. Guess what kind of site you need to have if you want to have any hope of ranking for the keyword glassware?
An e-commerce site?
Brilliant! Clearly, Google interprets the query glassware as having primarily commercial intent. That is, most people who search for glassware are looking to purchase glassware.
So if your site was, say, a museum of glassware, but you weren't selling any glassware, you probably wouldn't be able to rank for that term.
That's exactly right. It would be very difficult, to say the least. But you might have a much better shot at something like glassware history or glassware exhibits, where people are probably looking for exactly what a glassware museum would have.
So does Google think all single word queries for things have commercial intent?
No, not at all. Look at these results for the query muffins. Notice that they're almost all recipes for muffins.
I guess you wouldn't want to buy muffins online.
Well, not unless they hit overnight shipping. But some queries give more mixed result. Here we're looking at the results for a search on table.
Oh yeah, I see. So some e-commerce sites, some information content, and also some query deserves diversity in play. I mean, some of the results are about tables that are furniture and some about HTML tables.
Yes, so in this case, you could have a shot at page one for this query with either an e-commerce site selling tables or a page with information about HTML tables.
Well, that's fascinating, Eric. Thanks. Mm-hmm. Now, folks, understanding keyword relevancy to user intent is just the beginning of the work you need to do with keywords. Eric has much more about the next steps, including how to determine user intent for a given keyword, and then how to apply that to your SEO strategy in his column for Search Engine Land. We've got it linked in the notes for this episode, so be sure to check it out. Thanks again, Eric.
Absolutely.
Professor Dumbledore, I think I've got it. I really believe I've mastered the keyword ranking spell.
Excellent. Excellent, my boy. Perform it for me. Remember, mesothelioma.
Okay, here I go. Mesothelioma! Dumbledore? Professor Dumbledore, oh, what have I done? Could have been worse. I suppose I could have turned him into Rand Fishkin.